Hello and welcome. Recently, I prepared a test render in 3ds Max and V-Ray. I didn't care too much. I just added a few simple material and rendered. I want to do something different now. Re-render a scene which was prepared before with V-Ray. This is just a remake. Do not get me wrong. Therefore, this is not a comparing video. As I said and you see, I didn't give time for rendering in the max, so let's get into the TV motion. I imported the FBX file from 3ds Max and the first thing that I see is the ground inside the model and sunlight is passing through. I delete the ground and pick up the materials one-sided. In the settings menu, there are two-sided button which we turn on. I check the model for the other two-sided materials. It seems that it's okay. Now I'm gonna set the time to night time. It's getting brighter slightly, but we cannot work under this brightness. Therefore, I want to place lights first. I'm just gonna place neon lights for fluorescent. I prefer neon 02 because when you increase the intensity of lights, it's not getting desaturated. But this time, I'm gonna use white color. Therefore, I can use any light material. Since all lights are same material, I have to use a low intensity value material. 0.05 is enough for me. It's a very small value, hard to adjust, but it can be adjusted by exposure at the end. For the metal parts of the lights, I'm gonna use mirror material. For the metal joint chrome and suspended ceiling brushed aluminum. I can place the real lights now. I'm just gonna use IAS lights for this. I choose IES 10. Right under the fluorescent, shortcut is 5 for moving. Light rays should reach the floor, so I increase the attenuation. I copy the light now. I press the shift key and drag the light correctly by this line. To copy multiple at once, I increase the number to 15. It's also important to leave that instance. To make a cold ambience, I'm gonna increase the color value. Also, dropping the intensity will look better. I have placed the most part of the lights, so I can check and balance the exposure and others. To balancing the contrast of the scene, you can change the ambient value. You can see the difference of the screen space global illumination on and off. I'm going to copy the missing lights. This time, I choose to copy because I can assign different values. This time, I can use the instance under this curve of lights. The most important part is now. The reflections. For the right and efficient reflections, I'm gonna use reflection probes. The outermost lines define the boundary. It is the where reflection is lowest. The inner line is the point where the reflection intensity begins to getting lower. You should use these boxes where you want to render. I do not forget to compare it by looking at the reference render and trying to set same colors and lookings. In TVMotion, we cannot use ordinary bump maps. We have to use normal maps. Here I have one which I created. I'm gonna change the floor material. I don't have to use same tiling material. I'll just choose the smart concrete material and change its properties. You can change the color of the materials, even if they are texture maps. Nice, glossy floor is going to suit better, and I'm gonna decrease its brightness. Here this part, I'm setting the lighting of the fire exit test. We need to assign the texture to color and inside the glove. Due to texture is losing its color, it is needed to adjust the intensity a very low value. Here we have another glowing material. Now, only matching the camera angle and other render settings left. I click the Create Image button and save the angle for the photo. I click the More. After setting the field of view, I'm gonna check the render a couple of times and adjust the borders. Once I satisfied, I click this Return button and click the Refresh. For global lighting, I try different values of the ambient. I'm gonna decrease to increase the contrast. As I decrease the ambient light, the scene was turned to yellowish for this reason. I'm gonna change white balance and also exposure. There aren't any certain numbers here. Just adjust them as you want to see. Our job is very easy because we have reference render. We can increase or decrease lights by looking. For the final check, we need to set the quality of the screen to Ultra in the Preferences menu. If you don't have fast graphic card like me, you can just leave it to medium or low. It doesn't affect the final result. To change the final resolution of the render, I need to go Format menu. I'm gonna select 4K for this. Let me show you some volumetric effect. I'm gonna click the light and go to haze and click more. I'm gonna input the intensity, let's say 0.05. It looks good. Once we did all adjustments, this is the final render. Thanks for watching. Please click the like and subscribe if you like this. If you want to watch similar, like this video format, please type the comment below. I'll see you in the next video. Until that time, keep creating.